Hola amigos, welcome back to another episode of Project Ozone. And take a look at what I've done in the factory, guys. I use a lot of these bricks, and this is how I got the bricks. I'm using a barrel so I can grab the dust. I put the dust in here, so let's grab a stack. And these are all oak barrels with a little bit of water coming from the infinite water source in there. One is enough, I think, but I just put two. And you know that when I put a piece of dust in here, I get some clay. So once I get the clay, it's pushed to this oven here, the furnace. It cook it. We get hardened clay. And when you combine when you combine four of those, you get, of course, clay. And I don't see the recipe, but yeah, you can get clay from that. So as soon as I put some dust in there, it will take the dust. Once it gets water, it gets you get the clay. Put the clay in here, and then the clay is cooked. We get hardened clay. And the clay, I'm just being manually actually putting it here. You put four like that, and you get a bunch of bricks. And then we get, of course, the rest. So that's what I did for that. And we're going to use a lot of clay anyway. So what I actually am going to do in here is close this and put a bunch of dust so we can get a bunch of clay. Because in immersive engineering, we're going to use a few. Now, let me show you in here what I got, how did I configure this. Now, we have some stuff from the Nether. Not everything in the Nether, by the way, can be used in that magnetic craft. So let's say, for example, let's use a little bit of copper for demonstration purpose, and gold maybe, and what else? And tin, okay? So we can use this, for example, to get the like the vanilla ore, okay, from there. So we get a little bit of this, there you go, and some nether copper. And we could always pulverize, and we get four for each of these pieces, but if we go to the process over there, we get six for each, and a chance of having a little bit of bonus. So this is my factory. I'll show you in a second. So what I do is I go to the first tab in there. I put everything in there. And let's jump back in. You will see that is getting everything from that first level. And it goes in a loop all around this. So first stop, it will be here. So we'll get this is a galactic craft mechanism, so different sort of mods. So we'll grab everything from there, and then it will throw all from this side. It goes to this other chunk, so we'll grab the chunks. Now is it goes from a stack to singles like this, or two actually, a pair. So I was thinking that maybe put like something that will allow me to grab the stack. So to wait for the stack instead of pulling two by two, I don't know. So this is this dust, gold dust, is a bonus. So that one will continue all the way till it's grabbed from the other one over there. So you see it's working. In here, it will grab all the rubble. So every time we get a rubble, it will grab it. Put in there, then over there it will come through here, all the pebbles, I think it's called. Yep, so this one will grab all the pebbles. You see we have a piece of dust, that's a bonus, so it's not gonna grab that one. And all the dust, that's another bonus, I think. All the dust will go straight to this one that is whitelisted from magnetic graph and thermal foundation so far, and it will put everything back into this in here. So now from here I have to automate that to just put a furnace probably and grab everything and cook it for us. And I haven't continued doing this because I want to wait for so I can fly. We have the Stirling generator, and for now I put in some coal in there, and we can jump like that. At the beginning, I was thinking of doing it all down like that, and then I decided to put the carpenter's ladder. I think they look cooler. Anyway, in here, I want to put all that to all around the factory. Maybe put some grass. So I'm bringing the grass. What happened here? Oh, there. Okay, I'm bringing the grass from that over there to here. So let me grab. Actually, I need 3. Okay, let me continue this. I stop it so you can watch it where it's coming from. So you see all that is grass and it's coming from there. And I'll show you that in a second. That's the XP. So yeah, I'm thinking of putting the grass in here and all around this. I think it's gonna look cool. In here, what I did is I put the auto enchantment, and we have here from the liquid XP that I turn off. I remove this one because I have a lot of XP on this one, so we don't need it anymore. And it's grabbing that from this liquid tank. I just put it like a buffer so I can use everything on this one after. And we get in here, so I can enchant whatever I want in here. One of the things I enchanted was this strongbox that you saw over there. This strongbox, what is cool about it is that everything that is inside, you can actually pick up and stay inside. And this is a reinforced strongbox, okay? And is enchanted as well. I think I enchanted or I forgot, I remember. Anyway, I put the auto disenchanter here so we can put books and it will split them. So let's say we put whatever, flame 1 and efficiency 4. So you put it in there and you put some books. I think let's put 2 books. So we'll start working, I think. Idle. Why you're not working? Okay, there you go. And if we come back in a second, we'll have flame 1 and efficiency 4 divided. So we'll wait for that. One of the things I want to do actually also is put this magic. Oh, let me remove my stuff just in case from this one. And I want to put 2 magical woods and the golden back of holding like this. So I have reincarnating 1 in this. And then we can put back all this. So if we die, it will stay with us. And let's see here. We have flame 1 and efficiency 4. I guess it just needed 1 book. Okay. And we can put that one back in here. Anyway, so that's the way we can divide this. What else? I was making here the ender chest. Very easy to craft. By the way, there is a recipe for the blaze. You can use vulcanite, but also you can use gold and redstone, which is really nice. So we don't have to look for it on the nether. And I'm doing an ender pouch as well. And that will help me out if we want, for example, to send, for example, if we put this one in here, and then let's grab a hopper. Let's see, do I have a hopper? Of course, there's a better way, but to demonstrate. So everything we put on this ender pouch is going to actually open that in there, you see? So if I throw my toast in there, it will end up right here. No. Okay, why not? It should end up in there. And now it disappeared. Okay, luckily I throw my toes and not anything else. But let me dye that. Probably that's what I need to do. So let's grab 3 blue dyes, and we'll put these in here: blue, blue, and blue. You can make match every color actually. Actually, I think it's still there, but let me grab some bone meal because I think it's still there. I'm just going to put blue anyway after. But let me dye it back on bottom bit because I think I forgot to. Let's see. White. Let's grab this one and shift right click. And now they should be related. No? Why not? That's weird what happened there. Okay, I'm going to put it blue. I shift right click. You see now it's three blue as well in there. And now it should work, but I'm not going to risk it. Let me test it out with a crafting station. So we put the crafting station right there. And it should go in here. Oh, look at that. My toast is there. Okay, so it was okay the whole time. Let's eat to celebrate. Okay, so that's cool. So I can go mining, for example, in the New Worlds. And once I'm full, I can drop stuff in there and they will put it on this chest right here. But also you can go directly, for example, from here to my ME network, my chest in here, or anything else. So that's that. You can always put also a diamond. So if I right click with the diamond in here, if we are on a server, it will make this blue private. So even if somebody else use the same color, they won't have interference with mine. All right, so what I want to do today is continue a little bit with the quest book. We have, and actually I want to continue in immersive engineering, sorry about that, because since the last update that I did, those heat generators are crap. They don't produce nearly has like, 100% less than what it was producing before. So I was thinking that one of the things I want to do also, we have a bunch of this stuff in here. And let's look for some stuff. Actually, let me do it like this because I want to create feature non. What do we have here? Feature non dimlet, material default. Nether, no. What I want is none effect. Maybe I can look for effect none. Sky body normal. I want to create another dimension, probably something that will be better than what we had before on the first one that were floating islands. Effect none dimlets. Okay, so let me put one of these. And maybe I don't want to use any materials because we don't have the power to maintain any dimension. Look at that cost for dimensional shard. This is one of the one I want, so it doesn't cost that much. So I can infuse all my RF machines, 8,000 RF fatigue with normal, even near generating that kind of power. So this one is cost 10 RF fatigue, create cost 2,000 RF fatigue. So create, that's going to be okay. And I'm hoping to get something good. So effect none is the only one I think I'm going to use. But let's see if we can use something that will make it. Actually, effect none, that's okay. Water, look at the water, 3,000, 5,000 RF. So I'm not going to use any of the materials. I'm not going to use anything. I'm just going to use, for example, something that maintain cost is zero. So let's say sky, bright night. No. Let's see. Something fun. Green fog dimlet. No. Green color dimlet. Sky green color dimlet. Okay, let's use that one. This one will be zero ref. So let's use those two because I do want to go to a dimension and I need the dimension builder so it can start crafting that while we do other stuff. Okay. Of course, I put already this one here. So this is charge. And let's put that one in there so it starts getting power. And I think I'm going to use this one that we did the other day because it was really bad. So let's extract that one. Doesn't have anything actually, So effect none and sky green, that's it. That's the only thing I want for now. And let's call this random 2. Random 2. Okay, let's store that one in there. And maintenance goes 110 ref fatigue, so that's not bad. And let's throw it in there. We get to 100%, perfect. And current power is generating, so we can afford this dimension actually. So that's good. I'm just gonna take a look and see what we got. Let's see, terrain, Netherland, stone, water, control, wet. Okay, but doesn't matter because one of the thing, even if we didn't got anything special, what I want is some shards to go mine some shards. So I'm gonna do that right now, so I can throw some shards in here. Actually, let me put a better chest in there. Let me grab another chest from here. By the way, I never showed this slightly larger chest. What's cool about it is that you can put it next to a regular chest. And I crafted that one. You see, it's exactly the same, but it's the largest size. So I crafted that one. So when you put it, for example, in some place like that, it will cover the whole area, which is nice. I like how it looks instead of course, this one that you can actually see the chest. So I don't know. I thought it was cool, so I wanted to test it out. Okay, let's put that in there. Let's grab a diamond chest. Actually, I needed that chest, so let's grab back one. No, what are you doing? Okay. So we'll put one in there with iron. Okay, and we can use actually a little bit of gold on this one. So we grab a gold chest and I'm just gonna put it right here. Okay, so we have a little bit more and I can put that, look at that. Perfect. At least I can throw some stuff in there. So let's go check that dimension. You should have enough power. Yeah, it's getting a lot of power, so that's okay. Even if we don't have any power here, it's actually getting all the power. Now, what I'm going to do is take this time the charged porter, and it's not target set, so I need to shift-right-click to this receiver over here. And now, every time I use it, I will teleport directly to here, so that's cool. And now we can use... and this one. Now I'm just gonna save my game for a second and back it up just in case, because it happened a lot of time when I trace dimension that we end up in the void. All right, so world is back up. Let's call this random 2 world. Let's dial and see what we get. I hope it's a good one. And I hope it doesn't, it happened to me a lot when I'm testing like crazy dimensions with a creative builder's dimension builder, that sometimes I end up in the void and you die and there's no way you recover all your stuff. So that's why I'm backing up every time I do something like this. And let's hope for a good one. We have the green sky, which is nice. This seems to be a very nice place so far. So very old-fashioned world, I'm guessing. And a little bit of lag here and there. I don't know if that hasn't generated now. What kind of wood is this? Oh boy. Okay. So we have... mahogany wood, okay. Okay, not bad at all. At least we have a bunch of... at least we are finally in a world instead of on a floating... Oh, look at that. We have these type of cows. Undead commented about the liquid, liquefied cow or fluid cows, I think it's called. And we have over there something else. This is kind of a crazy place. A lot of trees. A lot of mycelium here. Twilight Forest tree over there. Okay, let's check that house. On this house over here, in every dimension, there's dimlets that you can get. So not that we need really a lot of dimlets because we have a ton from the mob farm. But we can always grab a few more. So we have unknown material, lime stain. And we have these ones in here. Let's see what we got. Liquid pink slime and cold taiga. Nice. I don't need you. So, yeah, not a very bad place. So one of the things I really want to find in here is shards. So I think, and I forgot to put over there. Let me put in here, back home. Actually, no, we don't need that because we have this, the charge porter. So I don't need to put even a marker here. So what I want to do is something like this. Okay. I need a way to repair this manilium. I think I'm going to have to bring some manilium, but what I'm looking for is shards. Okay. And what is this? Limestone. Okay. Let's put some torches. Do I need more stone? I don't think so. where are my torches? Right here. Okay. So let's put some torches around here. We have zinc, we have copper. So we have a regular world where we can start mining. But I do want to go probably at one level. We are white 50 right now. So let me see if we can find some dimensional shards. That's why actually what I need. And I'm not sure what level are shard. Let's see, does it say something here? No, it doesn't, right? Okay, there are some mods that will actually show you at what level you can find them. Unfortunately, not this one. Some tin ore. But after that, we're gonna make a world of that with that dimlet, so we can have as many shards as we want. Okay, we have copper. So we can mine regular stuff. Liverus, the Twilight Forest. Let me put torch in here. White 38. So I want to go to some level. Let me cut in here, and as soon as I find those charge, I'll let you know. All right, here we go. First dimensional shard ore. Nice. So that's what I wanted. Normally, they have a few around, but I guess that was the only piece. Oh, that was cheap. But this is level 17. So I think I'm going to keep going in here in what direction, see if we can find some more of those. Thorium ore. I'm gonna grab you. And I'll meet you back at home once I get a lot more shards from this dimension. Oh, guys, look what I found. A molten selenegil. A fluid cow. Really cool. And I don't have any of my lassos or anything. So I'm gonna have to come back here. Can we use the bucket in there? I'm not 100% sure how this works yet. Yes, look at that. Molten selenegil bucket. Not sure what this is used for. Alright. Cool. So we're going to have to come back with a lasso to... Actually, with the safari net. I'm trying to find more of those shards. But so far, I haven't been so lucky. I just found what we got. And I have a full chest of all this stuff of ores. But no at all... Nothing at all of the shards. So I'm just exploring a little bit around, see what I can find. And I'll be back home when I finish. Oh, look at that. We're back in here. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to keep exploring. And I'll meet you guys. Actually, let's go back because I think it's time to wrap up. But I'm going to come back in here for sure to get some shards. So let's use the charge porter. And okay, I just click once and we should be back at home. There you go. Didn't I dial interrupt? Okay, so what we got so far is nothing, everything that I have in here, and that's it. So I didn't get lucky at all with those shards. Where are the shards? Only one dimensional shard. Oh boy, that is disappointing. That is disappointing. Can I pulverize you? I don't think so, no. Okay, so the only thing I have to do with this one is a dimensional shard, but at least we can craft from that. We can craft the dimensional, I think it's called the infuser or something like that. Machine infuser. It requires four of you and some machine frames. So let's grab you and... Come on, where are you? Right here. Okay, so we have the machine infuser. And with this one, what we can do is that we can put a machine. So let's say I put this dimensional builder in here. And then I put shards in here. So as soon as that one is, for example, this one also, if I shift on that, you'll see infusion bonus, reduce power consumption. So some of the machines will reduce the power. So for example, if I want to do this bunch of cobblestones, let me actually sleep so the rain goes away, I'm hoping. Let's see if that's a thing or not. No, I can't. Okay, I should make a weather control soon so we don't have rain all the time. But yeah, so I can infuse that one. And I can infuse, for example, the crafter that I have in here. So this one requires power. But once infused, I think the crafter will also function with less power. Reduce power consumption of the tree. Okay, so I can use the power for the cobble gen. That will be much faster and use less power. But also, I can infuse these machines. The Dimlet Research. The Dimlet Research, when infused, is... Oh, that's it? Reduce power consumption... No, it's not the Dimlet Research, actually. It's the workbench that I want to craft. Work. Infusion bonus increased chance of getting all parts out of the deconstructed Dimlet. So this is going to be a good one. But before we start doing anything else in there, I want to start generating in immersive engineering, getting a lot more done so we can get to other kind of power source. But I think I'm gonna leave it like this for this episode, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and see you next time. Bye bye.